Right, this is part 9 of the WordPress creating a plugin from scratch tutorial, and on this part I'm going to cover CSS includes, so including style sheets on any particular page, the same way we did JavaScript and jQuery in the previous tutorials. And just before I continue on with any code, just something to note, this is the site I was originally putting my plugin I was creating on, which is my localhost/WordPress folder. I've now moved it to a new folder, which is sandbox PHP software WordPress latest. Since this latest I can always keep up to date, and I've old versions of WordPress to test on in different subfolders. And also you might notice a little difference in terms of this content. This is what it looks like with my newest code from this tutorial, and the old site which I'm switching from, which I've used in previous tutorials, has the 2010 theme, whereas this new site which I'm going to be using for this tutorial and future tutorials is the 2011 theme. So I'm going to cross this out now that we no longer need it, and I'm going to continue on with the code for this tutorial. So as I mentioned, this will be covering including CSS files. So I'm going to move to the file we use for includes currently for PHP and JavaScript, which is includes.php. And we're just going to add to this a function specifically for including CSS files. And we're just going to call it dbsync underscore CSS underscore includes. So pretty much the same name as the previous function, but CSS instead of JS. And I'm just going to space this out a little bit so it makes a little more sense. So similar to how we included JavaScript, there's actually WordPress functions for making sure that the script's only included once. The style sheet's only included once, sorry, and it knows how to deal with creating the right tags and implementing the correct directory. So I'm just going to note down that these are files specific to the plugin, even though we already know that since it's in the plugins folder. So the first thing to do, similar to the previous code, is, so this new function is wp underscore register, register style. So immediately you can see pretty much the exact similarity with how the JavaScript files are included, except instead of script, the suffix of the function is now style. And we include files in the same way, simply by using a name or parameter we'd like to reference this specific file for, with, and the actual full URL to the plugin. To the plugin file, sorry. So we're simply going to call this dbsync styling. Since this is going to be a generic style sheet for the whole plugin for now. And we're just going to copy this. Just make things simple. And replace, obviously, the file with the name of the style sheet. We're just gonna, well, shorter and more simple, we're simply gonna call it style.css, which is a generic name for a style sheet that covers everything. And the next thing, which is also pretty much the same as including, well, executing JavaScript files, instead executing directly including style sheets, is wp onQueue. file. Now, there is something I'm going to do different compared to the last tutorial, which is I'm only going to pass the parameter of the variable we'd like to call to include this style sheet. Since we've already declared the URL to the style sheet, we don't need to declare it again in the onQueue style. That is only an option if it's not actually registered already. So we can actually trim this out of our existing code. Just to shorten things and make it a bit more simple. And now that should be fine. And we just need to add a hook. So we've already got this hook here for JavaScript includes. And I'm just going to note this down that this is only for scripts. And we're just going to add one just by duplicating the code that's already there, since it's along the same lines again. Because the way you treat including JavaScript files and CSS files is pretty much the same, since it's client-side files. So add action WP head again. But we're just going to name this, instead of dbsync JS includes, to dbsync CSS includes, since that's the name of our function. So we've now got the function to include the CSS files, the functionality to deal with writing those CSS files into a hook, and the hook to actually include the function that wraps it all together. Now that we've got all that, and we've trimmed it down with this new way of onQueuing without providing a URL again, since it's already declared, we can now get to the part of actually, once we save this file, so save, we can now get round to creating the CSS file. So I'm just going to click new, file, save as, and in my HD docs, remember, this is a new directory. Sandbox, PHP, software, WordPress, latest, content, plugins, our plugin folder, which is dbsync, and style.css. Well, now that we have this file, we already have a piece of content to apply new styling to, which is the text and the tags that are produced from the shortcode. But to make the styling a bit more useful, we're going to have another tag. So we're going to make these tags easier to style by modifying them a little bit. So we'll go to shorts, .php, which is where our shortcodes are produced, and we're just going to add some div containers to this first piece of text, which is always included. So div id equals, and then I'm going to give it a prefix of the plugin name and something that makes sense to this unique piece of information, which is license copyright, since this is technically what this piece of text is. And we're just going to close this off before the P. And then we're going to also add an ID to this P tag. And get rid of the current inline CSS we have on this. So ID equals information, shortened to info, distrib, short way to write distribution, and notice. So information, distribution, notice, which is technically what that content will be that's added into the shortcode. So now that we have two IDs, we have an ID we can reference in the styling. And I already planned this before on the styling, which I'm going to add to make this text look a little more interesting and stand out a bit more. So I'm going to write the styling now for these. You can skip this part if you like, if you're comfortable with CSS. But it might be worth observing if you're unfamiliar with CSS, or you may be interested in expanding your knowledge on CSS. So first I'm writing the IDs I'd like to apply styling to, which are the two IDs we've just written in the shortcodes. So the first thing I have to do is for the, spell this wrong, license, copyright, I'm going to apply a background colour and write the hex code I want to apply, which this colour you will not recognise until you actually see it, but that's the same with all colour codes unless it's completely obvious. Colour, so I'm going to set the colour of the text and apply another hexadecimal colour code. And the final piece on this ID would be text align. So the text contained in this div will always go to center. And in the information distribution notice, I'm going to do the same thing. So just copy all these CSS properties and just change them a little bit. So this one would be FFFCC. And we're going to actually add a border to this one as well. So border, that's 1 pixel dashed, and the color we want to add to it. And change the color again, since this is going to have a different color to the other element. This one's not actually going to have a text align on it, so I'm just going to change that to another text property we're going to be concerned about, which is font size, not 0.7em, which is a way of declaring font sizes specifically in a universal size format. And we're going to make this text bold by using font weight bold. And add a bit of padding, just space the text out inside of the paragraph tag. So now that the styling's done and we have it included correctly, I'm just going to do one last thing, which is in last tutorial we had a pop-up to show an alert to just make us aware that jQuery is loaded and it's working correctly, but because this runs every time it's going to be a bit annoying, so it's best to disable it by uncommenting this alert line for now. And now if we go back to the page where the shortcode is and reload, you can now see we have a nicer styling, whereas before we had the black text for what was the copyright notice, and this text, which still is red, looks a little more nicely formatted, and they're both contained in a little notice box. So overall that looks nicer than it did previously. And this just gives us a more powerful way to work with designing our plugins, and just the key to any good web development and design, which is abstracting all elements of a website. So that concludes this tutorial. And hopefully the next tutorial will be up next week.